get some top coat on. Customer's gone out for their tea, out for their dinner, so they'll be back at 8 o'clock to a nicely fibreglass pond. Depending on how well this job went today, I was going to potentially stay overnight on that little bit of ground there in the van, but we've got an 80% chance of rain tonight. And remember in the very first clip I pointed out that suspicious bit of cover there and there. There, look. Rain's going to get in there. I'd rather rain get in on the top coat tonight, because it'll all be gone off by the time it starts raining, then have water get in there and have a big drying up operation tomorrow. Risk having it rain again in the morning, which it is, and then not being able to put the top coat on at all and having to come back another day. Fight the battles you can win. Fight the battles you can win. Minimal denibbing required on this job, as you can see from the sanding marks. One bucket is never going to do it. I'm not expecting it to. We're not going to push it to do it. That's why I've got the extra bucket out and the top coat in here ready to mix up the second batch. Back on it. For a non-tissue job, this has come out lovely. I do like that tissue, but sometimes you've got to draw the line. Just got to draw the line. Around that little shoulder, that's where the drawbridge is coming down on its hydraulic thing. A runaway roller, not often seen. Yeah, for no tissue being honest, it's coming out nice. As I said in another video, it is tissue is not required. The waterproofing, it's just for cosmetics. And we like a tissue finish, but we don't dislike a finish like this when it comes out nice. Nice resin wash on it. Good couple of passes with this roller vertically, stop it hanging and curtaining and draining. Wipe up any drips that you've got. Do a nice job. Do a nice job however you're doing it. However you're going about it. Wipe up any of them drips in case this goes off on me. Don't have to be scraping them up. that later. Let's move that light out the road now. Now, I am doing this from muscle memory because the way the light is working, I've got that bright light up there and I've got this blackness in front of me, so the contrast, like in a DSLR, it's working, it's struggling against me. So muscle memory to put it on and lay it off the correct number of times vertically. And then inspect it with that. Oh, you beauty. No wrong with that, mate. No wrong with that. Beautiful. A little bit, but I'm not moving the camera, not with this top coat going off. Still fluid, it's not going on. The top coat is about done. Not done as in gone off, but there's not enough. Well, it's finished now, it's done that. 5 kilos odd is done. Let's have a look at a non-tissue finish. See that slight texturing? That's the fibre pattern. Did fill it with some resin. By no means a shabby job, no means at all. You're not going to tell from there. You can only tell looking close up like that. And you ain't never seeing it when it's got water in it, but that's no excuse for doing a shit job. So rather than push it with that roller, I am going to, you will get two uses out of that roller. I'll clean that roller and go again. Finish the floor off. Yeah. Let me do that, clean this roller out before it sets rock solid. And I'll show you something, right? Did you see in the other clip? Again. Is it something you can see on camera? Probably not. Remember that bit over there? I did with black resin painted on the wall first, yeah? Much the same effect as using black resin. It don't look no blacker. That was just a test and a bit of a tip for you DIYers for helping you see pinholes, dry glass, air voids. Get rid of them with your rollers. Right, let me crack on, clean that roller out, and I'll show you the... That's a bit of an Alfred Hitchcock going on there, isn't it? Okay, 7:15. Day one on this job. Reminds me of my old days glassing, where I could do jobs like this size in a day. They're long days. I'll show you this the best I can. Can you see the undulations in that floor? So I saw these when I was showing the photographs and the videos very early doors. There's no point issuing something like that, because you're not going to mask off over, you're not going to mask that over with tissue. So glass. Now the dust is coming up. See the dust kicking up? This is what I mean by contamination. The wind's picking up, blowing the tarp about, and blowing dust about. Yeah, nice looking job all told, that one, considering there's no tissue on it. Happy with that. Right, next stop, back down to Kent, I think, if that job's ready. Never tidy up here. Yeah, so, just a better angle. This affair here, can you see, just, can you see that bit there, just there? Can you see that little bit there, just proud, yeah? That whole thing, cantilevers downwards like that, and makes like a drawbridge, so they can walk from whatever they're doing landscape-wise out there into the property. Absolutely champion idea. Never seen it before, probably will never see anything like that. Again, bridges and stepping stones, yeah, but a cantilevered walkway. So this is almost like a moat, isn't it, from the olden days. Right, let's get this van loaded up. Customers coming back at about 8 o'clock to their newly fibreglass pond. Don't forget to comment and subscribe.